Mark Liverman is here in New York with the latest on this. Mark, good morning.
Good morning, Anne-Marie. Well, at least one death is being blamed on the snowstorm. A man in North Carolina was killed when a tree fell on his car. The conditions hundreds of thousands have been dealing with since Saturday, they're not over yet.
A premature blast of winter is taking aim at a big swath of the southern U.S.
North Carolina is in the cold, icy grip of a mammoth winter storm.
The flakes began falling in the Carolinas and Virginia on Saturday. Soon, the region was anything but a winter wonderland. Conditions got so bad, the churches canceled services.
This is Sunday morning, and what you see is nobody there because the church is closed today. That sends a pretty strong message.
By Sunday night, more than a foot and a half of snow had fallen, and it still hadn't stopped. Across the region, drivers were confronted with conditions rarely seen in the South.
Terrible, terrible. That's why we had to pull over. I just called my work and told him, and he's like, well, you guys got to keep moving when it's snowing. I'm like, we couldn't. There's no way.
In some places, the snow was simply too much. Streets and highways were overwhelmed by snow, stranding drivers and forcing first responders to make a difficult choice.
We debated on trying to just get people out of their vehicles and take them either to a shelter or a hotel. But the problem is that if these cars are abandoned, once traffic's open, then the cars are going to block traffic.
The storm left hundreds of thousands of homes and businesses without power.
And yesterday, there were more than 14,000 flights delayed and more than 2,000 cancellations. That's according to FlightAware.com. Some of those cancellations were reported on flights from as far away as the Midwest. Anne-Marie?
Mark Liverman here in New York. Thank you so much, Mark.